We know people's names. We call the people we serve our guests. And we work really hard to ensure that they leave feeling better than when they came.
You're not looking at a high-end hostel or a spa for hipsters. Nope, it's a mobile shower on a bus. And it's delivering hygiene to San Francisco's homeless.
We basically take retired public transportation buses and convert them into toilets and showers on wheels.
That's Doniece. She's the founder and CEO of Lava May, the nonprofit responsible for this project. It all started with her idea.
I literally passed a young woman who was on the street crying that she would never be clean. And it made me wonder what her chances were for getting physically clean. So I went home that evening and did research. And what I found was appalling. There were about 16 shower stalls for 3,500 men, women, and children who literally live on the street. And I thought, that's crazy. This is not a third world country. And yet here in San Francisco, one of the most affluent cities in the world, we have issues with access to water and sanitation. I just started thinking, if you can put gourmet food on wheels and take it anywhere, then why couldn't you do that with showers and toilets?
Turns out you can. She got some old city buses donated and solicited a team to help.
We went through various design phases to understand how many showers could fit inside the bus.
That's Brett. He's the architect who designed the buses.
A very critical, fundamental part is reaching out to the homeless population.
So we talked to a lot of people and we did a focus group and we heard two things consistently. One was that if you're homeless, you spend your entire life in the public eye. You never have a moment of privacy. And the other was that if you're a woman or you're LGBTQ, the incidence of attack in showers is really high. So we knew pretty quickly that we wanted to create private, safe spaces for people to use.
So given the size constraints and user needs, they had to figure out how to fit everything.
We could really only fit two shower units, so there's complete privacy for two people taking showers simultaneously.
In addition to addressing the technical constraints and engineering challenges, there's also the creative part of the design process.
Thinking about light, space, and material, and experience.
So how did they turn their design into a reality? Enter Airco Mechanical, the company responsible for building the buses. They had a lot of questions.
We looked at it going, okay, how do we get two toilets, two sinks, two showers? How are we gonna build this?
That's Chris. He spent a lot of time working on these buses.
There's a lot of problem solving that goes on, and that's where the challenge is, and that's where the reward is solving problems.
That's Wyatt. He's in charge of Airco. The Airco team had a lot to figure out. How do you heat the water? How do you store the water? How do you waterproof the whole interior? The list goes on and on.
We had to go in there and just rip out all the seats and just get it to the bare bones of just a cold shell, and then take the architect's concept and then go in and start building the walls, putting in the plumbing, running the electrical.
But in the end, they figured things out. Here's how they got these buses to work. Carrying water on board would destabilize the bus, so they get their water from fire hydrants. They hook up a water meter, so they pay for the water they use. The used shower water is collected in a tank, and they have special permission to drain the water directly into the sewer. The sewage from the toilets, it's stored in a tank under the bus and then taken to a treatment facility. So far, they've built two buses. They call their first bus their prototype.
So knowing that bus number one worked, you take that pride that you did in that one and you move it on to the next one and go, hey, we're gonna make this thing better than before.
We launched our pilot in June of 2014. So to date, we've served just over 2,000 homeless San Franciscans, providing almost 4,000 showers for them.
There are plans to expand the fleet, and with each new build, there are bound to be new improvements.